I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life behind. Thunder.
You're listening to the Create What You Speak podcast. My intention is to change the lives of 1 million women, one podcast at a time. Now let's get started.
Thunder, feel the thunder.
My name is Sloan Fremont, and today I'm going to talk to you about The List.
Maybe you say.
Welcome to another week of the Create What You Speak podcast. This week I'm talking about The List, and I was trying not to sound too cliche with this topic, but I didn't want to use the term bucket list because for some reason, like for me, I don't know, I don't like that term. It's like, it reminds me of these things that like we throw into this black hole, like kind of with the attitude of like, yeah, that'd be nice, but it's probably never going to happen, right? So like, I'm just throwing all these ideas into a bucket never to be seen or heard from again. And at least that's my take on it. So feel free to call it whatever you want. But as far as this episode's concerned, I'm just going to refer to it as The List. All right. And if you're new to the show, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. So this idea about The List came to me after I was watching this TV show on Netflix called No Tomorrow. And as I was writing up my notes for the show, I thought, you know, I feel like I talk about TV shows a lot on here, but I've had a lot of free time on my hands lately. I've been, I don't know, I just haven't been going out as much. And, you know, I work from home, so I have the TV on a lot in the background while I'm doing other things. And so I found this show called No Tomorrow. And, okay, so first let me tell you, this show is kind of dorky and really cheesy, but for some reason I like it. And I think it's because the premise of the show is about this guy that believes that the world is going to end in 8 months, that the apocalypse is coming. And so he makes what he calls this apocalypse, which is where he writes down all the things he wants to do in what he believes is the last 8 months of that humans will be on Earth. So it's his list of all the things that he wants to do, which, again, it seems kind of dorky, but I really liked the show because it was about actually living your list, right? Like, because the main character in the show, he does something every day on his list. And for some reason, I liked that approach. I feel like it gave your all these things that you want to do, it gave like a due date and it required action. Since this apocalypse that he created, he put guidelines around it. And maybe that's why I don't like the term bucket list, because I feel like there's no guidelines around it and maybe that's why it feels like a black hole to me. But this really resonated with me because he had the guideline to do something every day from his list. And so then the show goes on and and he goes through doing the things on his list, and some of it's like to try crazy things, some of it's to make amends with other people, but mostly it's really just to live his life freely, like to really live it. And then it spreads out, you know, to other people that he comes in contact with, and he inspires other people, as, you know, TV shows do. And he basically lived by this principle of seizing the day, and it was actually pretty good in that way. And again, as dorky as it may seem, but it really was, the premise was to encourage people to live and not to get stuck into some routine or some job, you know, or whatever, some life that you don't enjoy, and really to get out and live and actually go after the things that you want. And so I was thinking about this in my own life, as I often do when something resonates with me. And I think for me, and maybe you feel this way too, is there's a lot of things I think about wanting to do. And some of them I do. I mean, I feel like I really do live a lot of the things that I want. But I know there's always more. And I know some of the things I want to do, they just seem so big that I just put them off, or I don't really think about how I might accomplish them because they seem maybe too big. And the show got me thinking, though. And so I decided to start my own list of things that I wanted to do. And so instead of doing it over the next 8 months, I decided mine would be over the next decade of my life. Which may seem like a long time, but I did it this way. And again, this just worked for me. So it's what resonated with me. But I did it first because I just turned 40 not that long ago. And it seemed like this was a good idea to have a plan, you know, some things I wanted to do over the next 10 years of my life. But some things I just can't determine when they might happen. Like getting married is on my list. I can't determine, you know, when that's going to happen, or going on some really big trips, right? Some of those things are going to take some, you know, some thinking through and some planning and all that kind of stuff. So there's things like that that I couldn't really plan in a specific time frame. So I think also doing it this way, it helped me to look at things a little differently and take some small chunks of bigger things and build on them if I'm doing something towards them every day. So for example, I have a lot of big trips on my list, and thinking about them over the next 10 years, it helps me break them down and take them one at a time and figure out, you know, get the money squared away and how much, you know, saving for it and all that kind of stuff, doing that over time. So making this list was a really interesting process to go through, because I started with the idea of writing down 100 things that I wanted to do, and with the hope that this list would grow. And I thought I'd get through 100 pretty easily, but actually I found out that I tapped out around about 60-ish, somewhere in there. And I had all these big travel ideas listed that I wanted to do, right? Like some of them were visit Spain, Dubai, the Taj Mahal, the pyramids in Egypt, the Great Barrier Reef in Australia, go to Aruba, Japan, the Philippines, Rio, go to Colombia and visit Pablo Escobar's grave. I mean, I love the show Narcos. I love anything about Pablo Escobar. I don't know why. I know the whole thing was terrible, but it's just really interesting to me that someone could come up like that and do the things that he did. Obviously, they're very bad, but there's still a level of interest for me. And so as I'm picking some of these places, I'm just like, why not? I mean, they seem interesting to me. Like, this is my list and I can literally do anything in the world I want to do. So why not do these things that interest me, right? And so then I included some things I wanted to learn, like learn to play the piano, learn to salsa dance, learn Spanish, learn how to scuba dive, learn how to pole dance, learn. Learning is fun for me and I like it. So I included that on my list. And then I had some super random things, like write a poem, hug a sloth. I don't know why I picked that one. That just sounded, there was this video I saw of this sloth, like this man helped it cross the road. And, you know, sloths move in slow motion, and the man put it up in the tree, and the sloth, like, turned its body in slow motion and, like, waved its little claw hand at the man, like, to say thank you. And all this took, like, practically 5 minutes to do because they move so slow. But I don't know. I loved that video and I thought, why not add hug a sloth to my list? I mean, who knows? Maybe they're very violent animals. I have no idea, but it didn't seem like it from that video. They move too slow. Okay. So anyway, hug a sloth, delete social media for good. That's something I would like to do. I'm not going to do that today, but that is on my list. Do a boudoir. I don't like that word. Boudoir. I don't know if I'm saying that right. Photo shoot. Go to an adult prom, make peace with my neighbor's barking dog. I think I've mentioned that on here, but I can't even explain that story to you because it just sends me in fits of rage, but that's on my list. Go to the airport and just pick somewhere to fly to. And I also had another good one was sell everything I own and travel the world for a year. I don't know about that one, but it just sounded good. Okay, then I picked some local things I wanted to do that I've never done here in Nashville, like visiting the art museum, the zoo, and the science center. And I don't know why I've never done any of these things and why I don't, so those got on my list. And so then, like I said, I started to tap out around 60. So I started to add some more things that seemed appealing to me in the short term, like little mini feel-good things. And some of them were just to see if I could do them, and some of them were because I was like, I wonder how I'm going to feel at the end of this. So some of those included meditating for 30 days, skipping Mountain Dew for 30 days. If you don't know, I have a deep love for Mountain Dew. I do. And so I put skipping Mountain Dew for 30 days. And I think I'm on day like 5 right now. But I put skip Mountain Dew instead of like not drinking, or I don't know, for some reason the word skip to me was better because it's like I'm just skipping it. Do yoga for 30 days. Eat vegetarian for 30 days. I'm not a vegetarian, but I don't like to cook meat. Like, it just grosses me out, and I don't cook it at home. So if someone else cooks it, I'm fine. But so eating vegetarian for 30 days. Getting 8 hours of sleep every night for 30 days. And things like that, right? Like, just some habits that maybe my life would – maybe I'd feel better if I did those things. And not from a strict regimented perspective, but more of, let's just try it and see how I feel at the end of these 30 days. And another one I had on the list was to meditate on the beach in Florida. All the times I've been there, I've never done that. So I'm doing that. I'm heading out there this Friday. So I plan to check that one off the list this week. So, okay. So now my list is at around 81. I've only gotten to 81 things I want to do in the next decade, which isn't bad or good either way. It's just what it is. But I'm just surprised that I only got to 81. I mean, but the good thing about this is this list keeps me thinking. It keeps me stretching. It keeps me like excited because I know there's more to come. And this I think particularly hit me because I was feeling very stuck lately, like just stuck. Like I couldn't see past my own four walls of my mind, you know? And I think if you're feeling that way, I highly recommend starting a list like this because it gets you out of those walls of your mind and it helps you to see the bigger picture and to look at things from a broader view and realize there's so much more to your situation than what you feel stuck in today. At least that's how it felt for me. And doing this was fun. I mean, it was exciting. And as I said, it helped me to have something to look forward to and, you know, focus on things that sounded fun to me, that were interesting to me and that kept me feeling alive. And I don't know, will I do all these things? I mean, who knows? And that really doesn't matter because, you know, our moods change, our desires change, and our willingness to do any of these things at any given time can change. And that's okay because this list isn't about being like rigid and checking things off like a robot just for the sake of checking it. And it's not about rushing through any of these just to check it off the list. It's about dreaming. It's about thinking bigger and about poking around on a map and seeing what places sound good and fun for you to go to and adding those things and planning to do those things. And it's about setting goals for yourself that sound fun and that excite you and that give you something else to focus on that feels good when maybe you aren't feeling so good or when you're feeling stuck or like everything is closing in on you. So as you move forward this week, I highly encourage you to start your own list and to do this exercise. Maybe start with 100. That's just the number I chose. That you don't have to start with that. You can choose any number, but and call it whatever you want, right? I chose the list, bucket list, whatever works for you. But the point of this is to get you excited about living again, right? Like your list is all the things that you want to do in your life that maybe it's the things you've thought of before and dismissed because you thought it can't be done or you thought it was too big or you thought there was no way. But I highly encourage you to put those things on your list because I promise you, you can find a way. And when you make your list and you start thinking about it, don't just stick it in a drawer, you know, and forget about it, right? Like take some action on it, do something, like take something, some action every day to, you know, work towards something on your list. And, you know, that's what I've been doing, even if it's a small thing, right? Like one thing, what can I look at my list today that gets me excited? And it doesn't always mean I'm going to cross it off my list, but as long as I'm making progress towards something that feels good, I think that's a success. At least it feels that way for me. And it keeps me focused on something that feels good. And really, when we're creating our own reality, that's the most important part, that you feel good in the process. So as you move forward this week, I would encourage you to give it a try and see what you think. All right, so that's it for this week on the topic of the list. I started the show talking about the inspiration I got from the TV show No Tomorrow, where the main character makes an apocalypse of all the things he wants to do before the world ends in 8 months. But you don't have to wait for the threat of the world to end to start your own list. You can do it today and start making a list of the things you want to accomplish in your life. And maybe it's travel, maybe it's learning something new, maybe it's getting out of your comfort zone in some way. Whatever that is, I encourage you to dream big. Making a list like this is such a great way to get excited about living again. It gets you dreaming, it gets you thinking, it gets you creating, and it gets you focused on something bigger. And taking action on your list every day, no matter what it is, big or small, it can help bring back some fun and excitement into your life. And at least that's what it did for me. It got me, you know, feeling like I was living again. And I hope it does the same for you. So give it a try this week and see what you think. All right, so I'm going to talk about the songs that I chose and then I'll close this out. So the intro song I chose is called Soul is Fire by Elliot Root. And I love Elliot Root. I think they're a local band here in Nashville. They have another song that I really love called June After Dark. But this one called Soul is Fire. And I like how he says fire in the song. It's like fire. Like, I don't know. He says like fire. He says it in a, it's like a very enunciated way. But okay. So verse 2 of the song goes, like the colder times and we're the cold ones warm. We sit in your house as you begin to claim what is yours. Know your name now, boy. No mistake. Dance the dance you wish to dance and fuck what people say. Dance the dance you wish to dance and fuck what people say. I really hope you bring that energy when you make your list and when you live your life. Like, dance the dance you want to dance. Do what you want to do and fuck what everybody else says, right? Make it your own. Do your own thing that feels good for you. So I really like that verse in the song in Soulless Fire by Elliot Rue. Okay, outro song, Learn to Let Go by Welshly Arms. This is like the anthem of my life, I think, or it should be. As it indicates, learn to let go. And there's this part in the song, he says, learn to let go. I'm losing control. Throw my hands up, learn to let go. Like, I think that paints a really good visual. Like, throw my hands up, learn to let go. Because that's sometimes how we have to approach life. Like, we have to learn to let go. Let go of the steering wheel, right? Just let go and free fall. You know, sometimes I've described this for me, it feels like I'm just falling through the air. But that is when the good things come in, when we can learn to let go. When we throw our hands up, we lose control and we're like, you know what? I'm going to let go and let this be. I'm going to allow this. And we're actually going to talk about that next week on the show. I'm going to talk about that and the difference between allowing and, you know, not allowing. That's not the word I'm going to use, but, I have the idea formulated in my mind. So, all right. So outro song, Learn to Let Go by Welshly Arms. All right, so that is it this week for our topic of the list. I would love to know what you think. I would also love to know what things you want to add to your list. Like, what's on your list of to-dos in your life? I am going to post this on Instagram, the picture for this week's episode, and I would love to get your comments on that and let me know what you think. What's on your list? You can also email me, SloanFremont@gmail.com. I have a website, SloanFremont.com, and my Instagram is SloanFremont. So if you like the podcast, please remember, subscribe, rate, review, tell all your friends about it. Let's get the word out so more people can listen. And if you have any questions, I always love your feedback. So please don't hesitate to reach out. All right, that's it for this week. Abracadabra, now go forth and create what you speak. Learn to let go.